Praise God. Good morning, Dare to Imagine.
Hallelujah.
Good morning. It is D2I Day.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Lord, we just praise your name. We thank you, God. It's been 3 years, believe it or not, and God has brought us a mighty long way. So we are here to celebrate, to thank God for what he has done in the life of this church, in this beautiful fellowship over the last 3 years. And to really thank God for each and every one of you. We are just so grateful to be able to be in this space, in this place. This is our first time celebrating our anniversary here at our brand new Dare to Imagine campus. Praise God. Amen. Yes. I continue to thank you, God, for your glory and how you have continued to bless us. Amen. Can we just go to God in prayer? This is an uplifting day. We're so excited. We just praise God for what he's doing. Dear God, we are grateful. We are thankful, God, for just who you are. God, we thank you for this reminder that you continue to be in the blessing business. We thank you, God, for your faithfulness. We thank you, God, for being the dependable one, God. God, we know that we would not be here 3 years later if it were not for you. So, God, we bow down, we humble ourselves in your presence, God. And we just want to say thank you, God. God, we are also so grateful to be able to celebrate in this new campus, God. For you, God, are the door opener, God. That there's no door that a man can shut that you have opened, God. So, God, we are just grateful for what you continue to do, not only in this church, God, but in each and every one of our lives, God. We ask you, God, to descend upon this service. May you be uplifted. May you be glorified. May you be recognized, God, as the Almighty God, the Prince of Peace, the Holy One, the Mighty God. You are El Shaddai, God. You are the Savior, God. You are the Jehovah Jireh. You are our provider. You are our protector, God. And we will continue to give you the praise, God, for you are so deserving, God. God, we are just grateful to be able to lift up our voices, God. May you, God, get all the glory. May every word that sounds, God, uplift your name, God. May every look that is given, every smile that is offered, God, continue to reflect you and your love, God. May we, God, point everyone to you, God, for we know, God, that if it were not for you, God, we don't know where that we would be. So help us, God, to never forget who you are and what you have done in each and every one of our lives so that we may help someone to dare to imagine, to know that life is better, to know, God, that they can be connected to you. For it's in your name we pray. Bless this service, bless these instruments, and touch every heart. Amen. Amen. Are you praise and worship God this morning? We hope so. We're happy to see our 9 a.m. and our 11:15 a.m. services together. One family, one church, serving one God. Amen. Praise him.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes. Come on, give God some praise in this place. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God, we thank you for increase all around us. Hallelujah, hallelujah. How many believe there's no limits? No limits.
Sing no limits.
No limits.
No boundaries.
No boundaries.
I see increase.
I see increase.
All around me.
All around me.
Stretch forth.
Stretch forth,
break forth, yeah.
Break forth,
release me,
release me,
enlarge,
enlarge my territory.
No limit,
no limit,
and no boundary,
no boundary.
I see
increase
all around me.
All around me.
Stretch forth,
stretch forth.
Enlarge
my
Hallelujah,
God.
Yes.
We worship your name,
hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You are worthy, God.
Hallelujah.
And we give you all the praise.
Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah. We worship your name, of Jesus.
Won't hallelujah. You stand up and praise God this morning? He's so worthy. You're worthy, God. We thank you for one, for two, hallelujah. For 3 years.
Hallelujah.
We praise your name, God.
Hallelujah.
You are hallelujah. The omnipotent hallelujah. One. You are magnificent, God. You are the holy, holy, holy. And we praise your name, God. We're going to praise your name, God. I'm going to praise your name, God, no matter what. Hallelujah, God.
Say no limit,
no limit,
no bound,
and no bound.
We see increase.
I see increase.
It's
all around me.
Stretch forth and grab your hand.
Increase
is here. The increase is here. The increase is here. Hey, yeah. Enlarge my territory.
Enlarge my territory.
Jesus, we sing the prayer.
Oh God,
Jabez.
Will you bless me? Bless me, oh Lord, bless me indeed. Enlarge my territory, oh Lord, bless me indeed. We pray that you bless us indeed. Say, bless me.
Bless me. Bless me. Oh, Lord, bless me indeed. Enlarge my territory.
I pray for increase.
Bless me indeed.
I pray for increase.
Come on, let's say that again. Say, bless me.
Bless me.
Bless me.
Bless me.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord. Bless me indeed. Enlarge
my territory.
My territory.
Speak increase over these people today.
Enlarge my territory.
That you may stand beside us and walk beside
enlarge
us.
Enlarge my territory.
Guide our feet in your way.
Enlarge my territory.
Enlarge my territory.
Enlarge my territory. Enlarge my territory.
Territory.
Enlarge territory. I pray for increase.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. On your word.
Hallelujah.
God, we bless your name today, oh God. As you lay on your people today, as you lay on your people today, hallelujah, we pray for increase.
We thank you, God, for how you've blessed us, God. Hallelujah. Praise your name.
Amen. Let the people of God say amen. How many of you are glad to be here today? Come on and give God some praise today. Amen. I want the praise team to come back out. And I want this brother Brandon to take us back, you know. And when you think about how far the Lord has brought us from, he's brought us from a mighty long way. Amen. And so, Brandon, I don't know what the Lord has on your heart, but I know whatever it is, it's going to be anointed. So come on, let us stand to our feet as we give God praise today. And as Brandon leads us in worship, I just thank God for what he is doing here in the midst of this fellowship. Amen? Amen. Amen. Come on and give
praise
Brandon
praise. The Lord,
praise.
Everybody. Come on. Do you want the Lord to increase your territory? Come on. Do you really believe that prayer on this morning? Come on. Let him enlarge your territory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. He's my friend. Oh, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Oh, he. Come on, clap your hands. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Oh, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Oh, he. Everybody clap your hands. Come on, if you know can't nobody do you like the Lord. Come on, put those hands together. Oh, can't nobody,
nobody
do me like Jesus.
Do me like Jesus.
Can't nobody,
nobody
do me like the Lord.
Do me like the Lord.
Can't nobody,
nobody
do me like Jesus.
Do me like Jesus.
Oh,
he's my friend.
Oh, he picked me up. And he turned me around. Picked me up. And he turned me around.
Told me around.
He picked me up. And he turned me around.
Told me around.
Oh,
he's my friend.
Well, he healed my body.
Healed my body.
And he told me to run on.
Told me to run.
Healed my body.
Healed my body.
Told me to run on.
Told me to run.
He healed my body.
Healed my body.
And he told me to run on.
Told me to run.
Oh,
he's my friend.
Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow.
Angels bow before.
Heaven on the door.
Heaven on the door.
What a mighty God.
What a mighty God we serve.
Come on, if you know it. What a mighty God.
What a mighty God we serve.
What a mighty God.
What a mighty God
we serve. Angels bow.
Angels bow before.
Heaven on
the door.
What a mighty God.
What a mighty God.
Come on, let's say it one more time. What a mighty God.
What a mighty God we serve.
What a mighty God.
What a mighty God
we serve. Angels bow.
Angels bow before.
Heaven and earth the door.
Heaven and earth the door.
Angels bow.
Angels bow before him. Heaven
yeah,
and earth the door.
Come on, we serve a mighty God.
It's a new season. It's a new day. A fresh anointing is coming our way. It's a season of power and prosperity. It's a new season. Heavenly Father, it's in the name of Jesus that we humbly come before your presence. Lord, to give you glory, to give you honor, and to give you praise. To thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be here this day. Thank you, Lord, for keeping your hand on Dare to Imagine. Thank you, Lord, for bringing us together as one body. Lord, we know without you, we would not be here. So yes, God, we say thank you to your will and to your way. We call on you, Holy Ghost, and ask that you take full reign of this worship experience. Continue on, Lord, from heart to heart and breast to breast. Move by your power, move by your spirit, so that we know that we are in your presence, God. Oh, God, you said that all things work together for good to those who love you, who are the called according to your purpose. Oh, purpose of God, to continue to work your work in the community, dear Lord. Purpose us, God, to continue to spread the word of Jesus Christ. Purpose us, God, to deny ourselves, to continue to walk according to your way, according to your will, and according to what you give us to speak, do, and say, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, we thank you, Lord, for our pastor. We thank you for our first lady, God. We thank you, Father God, for the vision that you've given them, dear Lord. Oh, Lord, we pray your continued blessings upon them, dear God, in the name of Jesus. For every man, woman, boy, and girl who's here today, God, and watching on stream, live stream, God, we ask, dear Lord, that you speak to our hearts, speak to our spirits, Lord. Remove everything from us, dear Lord, that will take away from our worshiping you in this moment, this hour. We praise you, God. We glorify you. We say thank you, Lord. Be pleased with our praise. Be pleased with our actions. Be pleased with everything we do as we do it unto you. In Jesus' name we pray. And with thanksgiving, we say amen.
Good morning, Dare to Imagine. So, hey, Pastor, I missed you. Good morning. So y'all know today is D2I Day. Give it up. Yeah, 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 get hype. And I am here to welcome you all to the sanctuary. That's a big deal. That's a big deal. And I'm very excited about it. So all of our visitors, our first-time visitors, please stand. Look at that. Yes. Have you all received a connection card? If you haven't received a connection card, raise your hand. One of our hospitality members will give you a connection card. Make sure you fill out the front and the back. And when you're done, you're going to take it out to the welcome table right there out front, and you're going to get you a free gift. Y'all didn't know y'all was going to wake up and get a free gift, did you? I know. Y'all can have a seat. Give a round of applause for our first-time visitors. Dare to Imagine is a social media-friendly church. Our handle is D2I Church, and I'm always tagging them in Facebook. They don't ever comment back, but I'm hoping to get a shout-out real soon. So y'all just stay faithful in the fight. We're going to shout you out at some point. So I am here to welcome you, to praise, to get excited about the Lord today. I want to welcome our guest pastor today. I want to welcome you all to let go of all the things that you came in here with that was holding you back from giving God that true praise. So as the band plays some music, I want y'all to get up, give each other some hugs. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. Today is not the day. It's D2I day, all right? Get up and give each other a hug and welcome each other into the sanctuary.
Let the people of God say amen. How many of you are glad to be here this Lord's Day? Come on and give God some praise. Amen. We thank God for each and every one of you. I am just tickled pink at what the Lord is doing and continues to do. I'm thankful that we were able to bring together both our 9 a.m. and 11:15 a.m. Crowds. And Sierra, if you come to 11:15, the sister who did the welcome, she normally comes to 11:15, but we were purposeful today because this is Dare to Imagine Day, and it's a day in which we celebrate and we give God thanks for our public worship service, our very first public worship service that we had on May 1st of 2015, in which we came together and we publicly said to Philadelphia that Dare to Imagine is here to stay. Amen?
Amen.
And so come on, give God praise for that. And so to kind of kick this off, there is a video I want to share with you. It is from the launch of the church. And I like to share with you videos about how far we have come. You've seen other videos that you probably saw this week of how we started out at the house. About 20 people came to hear the vision. And then we moved to Jerry and Ray's house. And now, then we moved on to 3801. Now God has blessed us with this campus. But I want to share with you the very first public launch of the Dare to Imagine Church on March 1st of 2015. As they prepare in the next few seconds to cue it up, and I'm just going to look for Wesley to give me the sign in the back that they're ready to go. So let's watch this video from 2015, March 1st, of our first public worship service of the Dare to Imagine Church. All right, well, I'm going to keep talking while they work on that. Y'all just raise your hand in the back. So let me just go through a couple of announcements here. Let me just let you know that God Talks we will have on Wednesday evening, 6:30. God is blessing mightily. God Talks is our Bible study. Thank God for that. We're going through this amazing series on just really Lent. This past week, I really dealt with prayer, and I'm going to pick prayer up this coming Wednesday, just showing us and teaching us how to pray and why it's so important during the Lent season. But also, we are, after I finish the prayer series and dealing with prayer, then we're going to go into fasting. And after fasting, then we're going to go into almsgiving as we continue our walk with God. So please come out 6:30 p.m. We have a great time in the Lord. And then, beloved, we also want you to know that we will not have new members orientation. Hold off on the video until y'all tell me. I want you to know that we also will have, not have today, new members orientation class because of D2I Day and because of all the activities that we have. But we want you to know about that. But also we want you to know that we had a great time this past Monday at Chosen 300. I want to thank all of those who come out so faithfully, the Chosen 300, and serve our brothers and sisters. Give them a round of applause. Wonderful. Our D2I career closet is in need of donations. I made a lot of donations this past week. I'm going to bring in some suits because a brother has lost a little weight. I can't go back, and I've tried to get them tailored to fit the new Luther. You know what I'm talking about. You know, there's the old Luther, the new Luther. And so, but please, please bring them to the D2I closet here. That D2I career center is going extremely well, and we thank God for all of those who are participating. And I believe, beloved, that kind of covers everything. Please be sure that you read through all of the scriptures each and every day during these 40 days of fasting and as we read the scriptures during the season of Lent. Do y'all have the video ready now? Wonderful. So let's start from the beginning with the D2I video of our first public launch. Amen. Thank you. let's give God some praise for how far he has brought us. Amen. And so, beloved, I'm going to ask for you today, because this is our first time worshiping in our own home, at our own campus. Amen. See it? You know, for those who were involved in Vessel, who had to get to the church at 7 o'clock a.m. every Sunday to set up. You see these TVs that are on the wall? They had to set those TVs up every Sunday, set up the sound system every Sunday. They were involved in the labor of this. And now the TVs are on the wall. So we don't even know how far the Lord has brought us from. Amen. And, you know, I didn't even have a place where I could go. I would just be in the hallway sometimes trying to get my mind right to preach. And so, you know, I got a little office now, so I'm just as happy as can be. Amen. It ain't got no furniture in it, but it got a chair. I'm happy. Amen. And so just thankful to God for what the Lord has done. And so we just really thank God. Let's just stand on our feet and give God some praise for how far the Lord has brought us. Amen. Come on and give God some praise. We magnify you. We thank you, God, for everything that you have done. Oh, come on and bless the name of the Lord, because he didn't have to do it. God blessed us not just with the property, but with nearly 7 acres of land. I'm here to tell you that's something to give God praise for today. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Amen. Amen. You may take your seats, and I'm going to ask you to do something special. Something special today. I'm going to ask for you, we're going to collect our offering, and you know the way in which we give here at Dare to Imagine. We encourage you to give via PushPay. We have a cool little app that you can download. The app, you just go to your Apple store, you go to the Android store, and you download the app. And when you download the app, you'll see life is better when you dare to imagine. And then you'll see it has a Bible, and it also has the giving app, PushPay. Or you can just go to PushPay itself and just text it to simply to type in D, the number 2, I, church, and text that to 77977. And I'm going to ask you, obviously, to give of your tithes and offerings, but I'm going to ask for you to give a special offering today for Dare to Imagine Day. If you can, give $100. If you can't do that, give $50. If you can do more than that, and you can give $250 or $500, whatever it is, we're asking for you to make a sacrifice today, because God has been mighty good to us. Amen? And so we want you to know that we thank God for how far the Lord has brought us and where the Lord is going to take us. And so we just thank God for you and for what the Lord is doing. So I encourage you to give the way the pastor gives, which is via PushPay. If you need an envelope, please raise your hand, and one of our ushers will be glad to bring you an envelope. But we want you to know that at least about 70% of our membership gives via PushPay, and we encourage you to do so as well. Amen? Praise God. Let's have some great music now.
Are we doing all right this morning, Dare to Imagine? I said we're doing all right this morning, Dare to Imagine. You're going to make me take off my coat. All right, now we got our own little song here, Dare to Imagine. This one goes like this. It's a Dare to Imagine. I said Dare to Believe. I said in something that's greater. I said greater than what you see. You all think you got that? Try to ask. I said dare to imagine. Come on and sing dare. I said dare to believe. Everybody sing. I said in something that's greater. In something. I said greater than what you see. Come on, sing. Put that all together, sing. I said dare to imagine. Dare to believe. In something that's greater. I said I'm greater than what you see. Everybody sing. Dare to imagine. Dare to believe. In something that's greater. Greater than what you see. Alright, everybody got that? We all got that, dare to imagine? Alright, we're gonna need your help when it comes back around. Come on, let's take it from the top. 1, 2, 3, come on. If you're here to celebrate D2I Day, you all can put your hands together. Come on. Here we go from the top. want to come Sunday. Come on.
Come Sunday morning. I know where you want to be. Praising the Lord.
But we're doing it a little bit differently.
Come Sunday morning. I know where you want to be.
Don't be shy. Sing, it's all right.
It's all right. Come stay high at
T2I. Sing it again. Sing, come.
Come Sunday morning. I know where you want to be.
Know where you want to be. Praising the Lord.
Praising the Lord.
But we're doing it.
But we're doing it a little bit differently.
Sunday morning. I know where you want to be.
Don't be shy.
Don't be shy. Drop on by.
It's alright.
It's alright. Come say hi and sing to us.
Alright, let's say it like this. Come on. Here to listen to the word. And we're here to lift up the truth. See, we're honoring tradition while we're doing something new. See, now our methods may be different, but the worship's still the same. See, our praise hasn't changed, you see. It's just church in the 21st century. Come on. Yeah, yeah. I know where you wanna be. I know where you wanna be. Come on. I'm praising
the Lord.
But we're doing it.
But we're doing it a little bit differently.
Sunday morning. I know where you wanna be.
Don't be shy. Sing, it's all right.
It's all right. Come say hi and be to us.
Let's take it to the bridge. Dare to be grateful and see what God has planned for you.
Dare to be healthy.
Give your body and mind a blessing too.
Dare to be grateful.
Hey. And give thanks for blessings from above.
And most of all,
what do we do?
We dare.
Come on, hey. Hey, 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 come on, come on, hey, come on, D2R rock side to side, if you know what you're doing and you're doing it right, if you're here to praise and praise his name, then come on, lift him up and let me hear you sing, come on, dare to imagine, dare to it's something that's greater. I said greater. This is when you're supposed to sing. Come on, I said dare to imagine and dare to believe in something. In something that's greater. I said greater than what. Everybody sing that.
Dare to imagine
and I dare to believe in something that's greater. Come on, let me hear you sing three parts. Come on, sing. I said sing. Something that's greater.
It's something greater.
I said greater than what you see. Hey, I said better than what to imagine. It's something that's greater.
It's something that's greater.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Take it up, come on, sing. It's something that's greater. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, hey, I said to dance and to believe in something that's greater. Greater than what you see. Don't be shy, drop on by D2I. It's alright, it's alright. Say hi to D2. Because the love is alive all the time. All the time at D2I. 2, 3, come on. I see.
Morning. I know where you wanna be.
Hey. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Amen. Let us bow now as we go to the Lord in prayer. God, we thank you right now. We thank you, oh God, for these gifts. God, we thank you for the spirit in which they were given. God, we thank you for just the privilege to be in your house. God, to worship with your people. So God, we ask now that every gift that every sacrifice that was made during offering, God, that it might be used for the further building of thy kingdom. God, we love you, and God, we thank you for this community called Dare to Imagine. God, we ask now for your blessings upon these gifts. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Beloved, today we have an awesome preacher of God. Amen. And I am very thankful today that we have with us Dr. Damone B. Jones, Sr. of the Bible Way Baptist Church. Come on, let's give God some praise today. While I can read Dr. Jones's bio, let me just share with you a little bit of a personal story. Most of the times, and I'd probably say most pastors, while they are a pastor, they don't necessarily have a pastor. I want you to hear that. So while we are your pastor, it's very seldom that you have somebody who's your pastor. And so for me, the men who have been and continue to be a pastor to me are my home pastor, Dr. Joseph C. Parker, Jr. in Austin, Texas, Dr. Calvin Butts in New York City. But very seldom do you kind of have people who are your pastor locally. And one is because whether we want to talk about it or not, the camaraderie is not always what it needs to be in the pastoral fraternity and sorority. And I remember when God placed on my heart to make a transition in ministry, I want to say the only that I can think of, the only pastor who reached out to me and said, "Hey, Kev, what you doing?" And of course, I wasn't doing nothing because I didn't have no jobs. So they said, "Come on, let's go get something to eat." And so we went over there in West Philadelphia. And he said, "What are you going to do?" And I said, "I don't know what I'm going to do. I said, I'm just trusting God and believing God for whatever God says to do." Because really, I had no intentions to ever pastor again. And Dr. Jones said to me, he said, "Well, whatever you decide to do, just let me know." He said, "If you need to utilize, you know, space at Bible Way, let me know." And at that time, pastoring again was the furthest thing from my mind. I had no intentions of ever pastoring again just because of the experiences in pastoring. And Dr. Jones, we met and we talked, and I really felt in my heart that this was somebody who was really concerned about me, concerned about my wife, concerned about our children. And when we finally made the decision that we were going to plant this church called Dare to Imagine, we needed a place where we could have baptismal services. And I called up Dr. Jones and I said, "Dr. Jones," I said, "do you mind if we use your baptismal pool? Please let us know how much it will be." And he said, "How much is it going to be?" He said, "People are being saved." I said, "Yes." He said, "There is no charge." I want y'all to understand that. And it wasn't just them allowing us to use their facility for baptism, but it was the fact that deacons and deaconesses were right there with us, making sure that the process, you know, went along well. And they would have all the things arranged, and, you know, there's a wetsuit that you have to put on and the robes, and we didn't have to do any of the cleaning of the baptismal robes. We didn't have to mop anything. They took care of everything. It was almost, amen, it was almost as if this was a Bible Way Baptist Church's baptism that Dare to Imagine was allowed to come to. I want y'all to understand this. And I appreciate that about Dr. Jones and about his leadership. Let's just give it up for them. We thank God for Bible Way. And so that's how he and I, of course, we've known each other, but he is an awesome man of God. He is one of my, he's never heard me say this, but he's one of my top three to the five preachers in this nation. I'd love to hear Dr. Jones preach. He is someone who is called by God. He has a bachelor's degree and a master's degree from the Philadelphia Biblical University, now called Carn University. And he has a doctor of ministry degree from the Palmer Theological Seminary of Eastern University of St. David's, Pennsylvania. Dr. Jones is tremendously concerned about our youth and particularly those who have been incarcerated. He has been someone who has walked with people and made sure that they have a friend and a pastor walking with them. And he has served on a number of boards and of panels and making sure that our young folk and that they understand that the church cares for them. But one of his greatest joys, or his greatest joy, is to be married to Dr. Melissa Jones. And they are an awesome couple, and we thank God for both of them. Amen. And they are the proud parents of four children, Aaliyah, Damon Jr., Alyssa, and Dominique. And so after our young people come forward and minister to us through dance, and then after, we are blessed by Sister Renee Smith through song. The next voice that you will hear will be that of Dr. Damon Jones of the Bible Way Baptist Church. Stretch your hands to Dr. Jones and say to Dr. Jones, preach.
Preach.
Dr. Jones.
Preach.
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 Dr. Jones.
Dr. Jones.
Amen. Let us welcome our babies and then Sister Renee. Amen.
Made it, yeah.
I made it.
Look out of my eye, yeah.
I made it.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Come on, while we wait, just let's stand up and just give God some glory. God is worthy. Come on, lift your hands, all ye gates. Be ye lifted up, ye everlasting door. We made it. We made it. We made it. 3 years, we made it. And it's only by the grace of God that we made it. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, saints. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We made it. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we declare today it's going to be the best day of our life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. If y'all can just clap your hands unto the Lord this afternoon. Give God the glory. Give God the honor. Hallelujah. If you're happy to be here, come on, somebody wave your hands unto the Lord. We're going to make some declarations today. Hey, God. Today will be the best day of my life.
Today will be the best day of my life.
Today will be the best day of my life. Oh, yes, it will. Hey. Get my joy back, yeah. I get my heart back, yeah, yeah. Oh, I get my life back, yeah. For today will be, yeah. Today will be the best day of my life. Oh, yes, it will. If you can come, come on, declare it with me. Today you will be the best day of my life. Oh, yes, it will. Oh, yes, it will. I get my joy back, yeah. Yeah. I get my heart back, yeah. Yes, I will. Yeah. I get my life back, yeah. For today will be, today it's gonna be. Today will be
the best day of my life.
I believe that today is gonna be, yeah.
The best day of my life.
I believe that today will be
the best day of my life.
I believe that today.
The best day of my life.
I day. Today is the best day. Today is gonna be the best day. Today, right now, it's gonna be the best day. The best day of my life. I believe. I got healing, yeah. I got deliverance, yeah. I got joy today. I got peace today. I got love today. The best day of my life. The best day of my life.
Could we all take a moment and stand to our feet? We stand to our feet, and I want us to thank God for Dr. Kevin Johnson. I said I want to thank God for Dr. Kevin Johnson, for his lovely wife, and for his children. Come on, y'all can do better than that. This is your leader. Amen, amen. You may be seated. You know, I was thinking as he was telling the story, when we went out to eat, and when he was telling me that, you know, the Lord had placed it upon his heart to start a church. Well, knowing him, you know, when somebody says the Lord said something, I don't challenge that. And knowing him, I know he wasn't, you know, some people just say it. But knowing him, I knew he was for real about that. But I gotta tell you the truth, though. When he said the name of the church, I said, that sounds like a cruise ship or something. You know, it don't sound like church, you know. And let me tell you why I say that. You may not know, but there is a shift going on in the church world. And people are not going to church like they used to. Did y'all hear what I said? People are not showing up in the sanctuary like they used to. So there's this new train of thought coming out that says that, and it's not new, it's really biblical, but the iteration of it is new. You can't put new wine into, come on y'all, into old skins. And so your pastor was ahead of the curve before the shift started. And most people would have said, you know, when they said, what's the name of the church? Dare to Imagine. Most people said, dare to what? And yet he was seeing what everybody else was missing before the shift started. Some of you will remember Lewis and Clark from your school days. Lewis and Clark trained and got ready and prepared for this expedition. They put everything they had in their canoe. They knew how to navigate the rivers and the waters and all that kind of stuff. They knew how to plow the course, read a map, and they saw this big mountain, and they knew once they got on the other side of the mountain, they would just carry the canoes up the mountain, come down the other side, get back on the river, continue the journey. What they didn't know was that they miscalculated. And once they got to the mountain and got up to the top and went down the other side, there was no water. As far as they could see was just land. And so what they were trained for to get to where they were was not enough to take them where they needed to go. They were trained to be in a canoe and on water, but now you got to carry that canoe over some different terrain. Your pastor has navigated you over that mountain. Y'all ain't hearing what I'm trying to tell you. He is one of the few people in the country who saw this shift happening before it happened, and he dared to imagine. And look at y'all now. I wish y'all understood what I was trying to tell you. and I'm not, I ain't playing when I say in the country. I was in a conference about 2 weeks ago with Bishop Jakes and a whole bunch of big names, Jamal, names that you would know. And all of them are trying to figure out what to do about this new thing that's happening in the church. And your pastor, let me go on to preach, y'all ain't here. He figured it out, saw it, and responded, and now you got Dare to Imagine as a national model of what ought to be happening today in this world. So I'm just saying, thank God for you, and thank God for your faithfulness and listening to what God has to tell you. So, all right, let me hurry up, because I got to get back to Bible Way soon, because they ain't coming to church like they should be, so I got to get back. So Psalm 122. And I want to thank my brothers who are here with me. We've got four of our preachers from Bible Way. Three. Why don't y'all stand real quick? Glad to have y'all with us. Psalm 122 says this: I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet have been standing within our gates, O Jerusalem. Jerusalem is built as a city that is compact together. Where the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord, to the testimony of Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. For thrones are set there for judgment, the thrones of the house of David. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May they prosper who love you. Peace be within your walls, prosperity within your palaces. For the sake of my brethren and companions, I will now say peace be within you. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek your good. Today I want to briefly use as a thought, glad to be in the house. Glad to be in the house. The Hebrew title for the book of Psalms is actually the book of praises or songs of praise. In the English language, the word psalm is derived from the Greek word psalmos, which literally means pious songs or music of stringed instruments. The book of Psalms is therefore a book of praise. And it was originally written and designed to be set to music and sung in the public worship. So the Psalms are really intended to express the worshipers' emotions as they interacted with God in the context of their own personal experiences. I had a professor in graduate school. His name was Dr. Earl Rodmacher. He said that the Psalms are written in the language of the human spirit. They are the utterances of the soul. They are not cool reason prose, but deeply emotional works that use wrenching language, dramatic exaggeration, and figurative speech. The Psalms then are a collection of writings of at least 6 authors, and at least 37 of the Psalms are credited to David, that sweet psalmist of Israel. The individual Psalms are usually classified according to their content. And so you have what we call didactic Psalms. These are Psalms that give instruction. And then you have messianic Psalms. These are Psalms that contain prophecies relative to the coming of the Messiah. You have imprecatory Psalms. These are Psalms that plead with God to punish the wicked. You have penitential Psalms. These are Psalms that express not only the feelings of a repentant heart, but also appeal for divine cleansing. Then you have Psalms of lament. These express concern in desperate and dire circumstances. And then, of course, you have Psalms of thanksgiving. And these reflect individual and community praise simply for the goodness of God. But there are other Psalms that are classified also according to their titles. And these are called Psalms of degrees or Psalms of ascent. When you look carefully at your Bible, you will note that in small print, somewhere just above verse 1 of the text, you will find what we refer to as the superscription. Superscription. Super means above. Script means to write. That which is written above verse 1. You will see the words, a song of ascent or a psalm of degrees. Now, in the Hebrew, degrees or ascents literally means elevation. So it refers to the action or journeying to a higher place. It has to do with moving to a station of superiority. It has to do with rising or ascending or moving up or going higher. It's elevating, it's graduating, it's degrees, it's climbing steps to reach the higher stories. It's moving, if you will, to another level. So the title of Ascents or Degrees gives us today a window into understanding the purpose of these kinds of psalms. So songs of ascents or psalms of degrees were sung by the people of God as they journeyed from all around toward Jerusalem, the place of worship, and they sung these songs as worship began. And you should know that the city of Jerusalem was located geographically in a place that was elevated. It was out on a hill so that you could see the holy city from miles around as you approached. So that as the worshipers journeyed, they were heading to a higher place than where they previously were. David wrote this psalm so that the people of God could sing it on their way as they were going up to Jerusalem to celebrate in worship. And I just want to tell somebody that when we come to worship, we're supposed to be climbing to another level in our walk with the King. Be careful of participating in anything in the church that does not help you get to a higher level. Every time we come to worship, we're supposed to be leaving some things behind and rising above some of the mundane irritations of life to commune on a higher level with the omnipresent God. We're supposed to be leaving some things behind. So you ought to stop worrying about your bills. They will be on your table, still unpaid, when you get home. So you might as well rise above it. Stop worrying about being laid off. If you're going to be laid off tomorrow, there's nothing you can do about that today. So you might as well come to church and rise above that. Stop worrying about who walked out of your life. Some relationships are for a reason and some are for a season. Come on to church and rise above that stuff. I'm saying when you come to worship, there are some things you have to leave outside and some things you have to rise above. Okay, somebody talked about you. You got to rise above that mess. Somebody didn't speak to you. You got to rise above that. Somebody didn't fall at your feet and worship you. You got to rise above that stuff. Somebody didn't return your text. You got to rise above that. Somebody didn't like your post. You got to rise above that stuff. You weren't invited to the meeting. You weren't invited to the party. You got to rise above that stuff. Nobody asked you about your opinion. You have to rise above that. Because when you come to worship, there are things you need to get above and some things you need to leave outside. If you really want to go to another level with the King of Kings. There's an old song they sing, and I appreciate you taking us back with some of them old songs. We don't get to hear a lot of that anymore. But there's a guy named Johnson Oatman Jr. who said it like this. He said, I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Still praying as I onward bound. Lord, plant my feet on solid ground. And when you read Psalm 122, understanding the context and the background, you start to get a sense of a weary, worn out, bedraggled people who are beginning to get excited and impassioned as they feel their feet standing on holy ground. No matter where they journeyed from, no matter what was going on where they came from, they were finally on their way and they were finally coming into the holy city of Jerusalem, which, by the way, means place of peace. These songs of joy, coupled with their anxious anticipation of worship, began to well up inside the worshiper as their feet finally stood within the gates of the holy city. The worshipers were excited. The worshipers were eager. The worshipers were wound up. They were energized for worship. Now, why are they so wound up and excited and energized to go to the temple? Because in their time, they associated the temple with the presence of God. And that's born out of that Old Testament concept called the tabernacle. Now, of course, the tabernacle was really a tent that the people of God took with them wherever they went, because it symbolized and suggested the very presence of God. So whenever there was a reference made to the house of God, excitement filled the air. Why? Because they just couldn't get enough of the presence of God. You see, the Hebrews were not just into the presence of God. They enjoyed the presence of God. That they were always looking for opportunities to go to the temple. It was not an inconvenience for them. It was not an intrusion upon their lives. They were not complaining that they had to give up their day off. They understood that it wasn't their day in the first place. It was the Lord's day. They understood that it wasn't only because of God that they had a job and a family, however much money they had in the first place. They never used those things as excuses as to why they couldn't show up in worship. Peter and John were going to worship at the hour of prayer, and that was on a Monday. Psalm 137, the people of God were upset and didn't want to sing the songs of Zion because they could no longer see the temple, and since they couldn't see the temple, they couldn't feel his presence. David even got excited about it, and he said in Psalm 23, "Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." And then he said in Psalm 27, "One thing have I desired of the Lord, and that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple." So I'm just trying to tell you that true worshipers are always glad to be in the house. And so this is why you have the words of the text. I was glad. Glad in Hebrew means to brighten up. Glad in Hebrew means to cheer up. Glad in Hebrew means to make glad. It means to make joyful. It means to make merry. It means to cause to rejoice. I was glad when they said unto me. They got excited when somebody said, "Let's go to the temple. Let's go." That word "go" is an interesting word. That "let us go into the house of the Lord." Go in Hebrew means human locomotion. It's motion. It's moving from point A to point B. And if you are a real believer in Jesus Christ, your entire life is to be spent going from point A to point B, going from where you are to where God wants you to be. Let us go unto the house of the Lord. But "go" also has a figurative meaning in the Hebrew. It's the characteristics of one's lifestyle. Because this concept of "go," human locomotion, is the New Testament equivalent to walking. So that in a figurative sense, going has everything to do with how we live. Because when you read the word "walk" in the New Testament, it's about how you live. And that's why we call it a Christian walk. So I think they were excited to be going to worship because they had a lifestyle that was consistent with a desire to dwell in the presence of Almighty God. They wanted to hear the word from the man of God. And you see, it's hard to want to dwell in a person's presence or even hear from a person when you don't have a positive, ongoing relationship with that person. And by the way, I'm not talking about just coming to church because that's what you can do. You can be in sin and show up in church. I'm talking about people who were on fire. They were passionate about it. They were excited about being in God's house. You see, some of us come to church, but then there's other of us who came to worship. When you're not living right, there's no urgency to come to church and to worship. When you're not living right, there's no real desire to be in the presence of the Lord. When you're not living right, you would really rather run and hide. You remember Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden when they knew that they were no longer in fellowship with God? When they knew that they had messed up, they weren't running to God. They were running from God. You remember Jonah God gave him an assignment, and because he disagreed with God, he tried to run away from God. But these people in this text couldn't wait to get in the presence of Almighty God, because for them, anticipating being in his presence meant hearing from him. And so when you come to worship, you ought to anticipate hearing from the Lord. And by the way, that's why you ought to praise God for your preacher. I say it again. I said, by the way, that's why you ought to praise God for your preacher. That's why you ought to be shouting over the fact that God gave you a good pastor. He is the mouthpiece of God. He is God's messenger to your heart. He is a Galahad of the gospel. He is the watchman on the wall, watching out for your soul. He is your under-shepherd, leading and guiding you as the Lord leads him. And so the text suggests that they were anxious to get to the Lord's house. Now, in Hebrew, house can be a tent. It could be a hut. It could be a mansion. It could be a palace. It could be a temple. Regardless of what the building is like, it's a dwelling place. It's a place where somebody lives. these people were going to where they knew the Lord was because it was the Lord they wanted to encounter. They were on their way to God's house. Now, when you read the text carefully, you'll clearly see that there were some things that they knew would go on in the Lord's house when they got there. Now, they weren't going just because they had to go to a meeting. They weren't going just because they had to have rehearsal. They weren't going just because it was a concert. Y'all ain't helped me at all here. They weren't going because it was somebody's anniversary. They didn't go just because it was Dare to Imagine Day. They didn't go just because it was another program. They didn't go because it was a banquet. They didn't go because they just wanted to eat. They didn't go because it was their night to sing. They didn't go because it was their night to usher. They didn't go because it was their day to lead praise and worship. They went because they wanted to fellowship, number one, one with another. That's why verse 4 says that they saw themselves as tribes. Now, in the Hebrew, the word tribe really means a rod or a staff. And I get it. That's a weird thing for the word tribe to mean, rod or staff, because those were the instruments used by a shepherd to rule and keep the tribe together. The tribe then was a family. So the Hebrews were excited at the opportunity to fellowship one with another because they saw themselves as members of the same tribe and members of the same family. So that every time they went to the temple, it was a family reunion. They just couldn't wait to see each other. And in the same way, we are supposed to be family with God as our fathers and sisters and brothers are we. Now, the one thing that keeps families together better than anything I've ever seen is love. And just about all of the one another exhortations in the New Testament are really demonstrations of love in action. As a matter of fact, in the New Testament, the words one another are used some 58 times. 40 of those times, it was used by the Apostle Paul alone. But if you think about it, it really hinges on doors of love. So Romans 12, 5, we are members one of another. Romans 12, 10, we should be devoted to one another. Romans 12, 10, we should honor one another above ourselves. Romans 15, we should be of the same mind with one another. Romans 15, 7, we should accept one another. Romans 15, 14, we should admonish one another. Romans 16, we should greet one another. Galatians 5, we ought to serve one another. Ephesians 4, we should bear with one another. Galatians 6, we got to bear each other's burdens. Ephesians 5, we got to submit to one another. And 1 Thessalonians 5, we have to encourage one another. And the reason is because we're supposed to be family. And if we're family, then we ought to act like it. We're supposed to be a family. But then the text says there's something else they came to do. Verse 4 says they came to give thanks to the name of the Lord. And I don't know, I can't tell right now, but has anybody in here got something to thank God for? I mean, is anybody in here that understands that if it had not been for the Lord on your side? I mean, is anybody here that really honestly has an attitude of gratitude? I mean, has the Lord been good to anybody in here? I mean, has he been blessing anybody? Has he done something for you that you didn't deserve to have done? Has the Lord been good? Has he been watching over you? Has he been keeping you? I wish there was somebody that had something to praise God for. I don't know about you, but I'm better. I'm stronger. I'm wiser than I was just a few years ago. The Lord has been keeping me. And I got to thank him for what he did for me through his own son. But yet there's another interesting thing that they do when they get to the Lord's house. Verse 6 says that they prayed for the peace of Jerusalem. Now don't miss this. They didn't come to church just to enjoy themselves. Seems that these people were not content just to have a good time among themselves when they got to church. Being in the presence of God and thanking him for how he has blessed them was good, but that's not all they came for. Fellowshipping with each other was good, but that wasn't enough either. These people were not only internally focused, but they had some external concerns. Because once you leave the church, you got to live in that city. I wish I had some witnesses in here. I'm saying they prayed for the peace of the city. I would suggest today that a church is not a church unless it impacts the community where it is located. I got to say that again. The church is not a church unless it impacts the community where it is located. These people thought enough about the city of Jerusalem to pray for that city. And I think we ought to be praying for this nation. I said, I think we ought to be praying for this nation. We ought to be praying for this commonwealth. And we ought to be praying for this city. I think we ought to be praying for every municipality and borough.
We ought to be praying for every county. We ought to be praying for the entire Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And if ever there was a time to be praying for our nation, it's right now. We still got kids killing kids and babies making babies. And in Washington, there's scandal after scandal, day after day, literally moment by moment. I think it's about time to send somebody to Washington that has some integrity. Some of y'all slow in here. We still got drug users and drug abusers. We still got homosexuality and lesbianism and prostitution. We still got danger in the streets and senseless violence. We still got children being neglected and mistreated and abused. We still have substandard housing, substandard public education, police brutality, high unemployment, rampant racism, and a prison industrial complex that's taking us back to Jim Crow. If my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sin and heal their land. And so I'm just trying to tell you today that these people in the text were glad to be in the house. As a matter of fact, they got excited before they even got to the house. If you really got a bona fide praise inside of you, you can't hold that until you get to the church house. If God has really been good to you, you can't contain that. I know you got dressed. I know your clothes are coordinated. I know you got your little hair did. But if God has really done something for you, you can't hold that shout until you get to the sanctuary. If he's blessed you, you can't be cool about that. If you're sure enough saved, you got to let that out. The text says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. So worship wasn't something they did when they got to the building. I tell you, there's just something about going to the house of the Lord. Nehemiah said, we will not neglect the house of God. Psalm 26, Lord, I love the habitation of your house. Psalm 84, blessed are those who dwell in your house. Psalm 132, let us go into his tabernacle and worship at his footstool. Psalm 84, for a day in your courts is better than 1,000. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. There's just something about the house of the Lord. And let me hurry up and get out of here. Listen, this is the last thing I want to tell you. It's good to be in the Lord's house, but the Lord's house is not a motel where you just passing through on your way somewhere else. It's not a mortuary, not supposed to be full of dead, lifeless people. It's not a nightclub where you come dressed in almost nothing looking for something. It's not a vacation spot where you come through once a year. It's not a circus where you come to put on your little show. It's not a parade where you come to strut and show off. It's not a social club where you come to socialize out in the hall. It's not a ceramic shop where you have to tiptoe around folk feelings. It's not a factory where we have to work only if we get paid. It's not a storm cellar where you run just because there's a storm. It's not an ice house where people have cold hearts. It's not a theater where you come to be entertained. And it's not a fashion show where you come to model your stuff. That's not what God's house is all about. As a matter of fact, the Lord's house is a restaurant. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. The Lord's house is a hospital because there is a bomb in Gilead. There is a physician there. It's a service station where you can pull in and get filled up and properly aligned and your batteries charged for the journey ahead. It's a dry cleaner because if you confess your sin, he's faithful and just to forgive you of your sin and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. It's a lumber yard. He gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the building up or the edifying of the body of Christ. It's a GPS system. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he'll direct your paths. It's an insurance agency because we are sealed until the day of redemption. That's what God's house is supposed to be. But most of all, it's a place of worship. It's a place where you can magnify the Lord for his limitless love. It's a place where you can honor God for his amazing grace. It's a place where you can bless God for his limitless power. It's a place where you can exalt God for his infinite wisdom. It's a place where you can adore God for his abiding presence. It's a place where you can praise God for who he is and what he's done. so that when you come to church, you ought to praise his name. And you ought to praise him like you got no sense. Because when you praise his name, he will lift your burdens. When you praise his name, he will soothe your doubts. When you praise his name, he will calm your fears. When you praise his name, he will revive your faith. When you praise his name, he will restore your joy. When you praise his name, he will fill your cup until it overflows. When the praises go up, the blessings will come down. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. So I'm glad to be in the service one more time. He did not have to let me live, but I'm glad. I said, I'm glad to be in the service one more time. Do I have a witness? Do I have a witness? Anybody glad to be in the service?
Amen. Come on, let us stand to our feet and give God praise today for Dr. Damone B. Jones, Sr. As we stand to our feet, there's somebody here today. There's somebody here as we give God thanks for yes, Dare to Imagine, but Dare to Imagine is only what it is because people turn their lives over to the Lord. And if you don't have a relationship with God, we invite you now to come. If you already know who God is and you accepted him some time ago into your life, but you've been looking for a church, you've been looking for a place where you can worship, and you've gone to this church, you've gone to that church, and the reality is there are no perfect churches and there are no perfect pastors, but we know that there is a perfect God. And so today, beloved, today we invite you now to come to walk down the aisles. If you're afraid to walk down, just reach out to somebody next to you and say to him or her, do you mind walking with me? Tell them, I really want to join the church. I really want to be a part of the fellowship. I really want to be a part of what the Lord is doing. Oh, we see you coming. We see you coming. There's somebody else. We see you coming.